Hi, welcome back to More Than a Garden. My name is Erin, and today I've got a lot to show you. The garden is coming along so beautifully. I can't wait to show you all the things that are happening there. This is the best garden that I have ever planted, made. I'm so excited about it. So there's that. There's also the chickens are growing. Coop is almost ready, and I'll show you how Sean is getting that all together. It's beautiful. It's amazing. It's amazing. The guy's amazing. That's why I married him. He's amazing. Let's show you the garden now. It's kind of thinking a lot. The past few weeks, I haven't done many videos, and I was kind of deciding whether or not I should fade away into the ether of YouTube world, float away, and disappear into the ether, or should I become YouTube famous? But not today. Today, we're gonna go and look in the garden. So come along. All right, so I'm going to start with the no-dig garden bed that I had built in an earlier video. And I'll try to link that somewhere up above or down below or somewhere. But this is the no-dig garden bed, and it's coming along well. I did put some tomatoes. I think I put some black creme in here. I got to look at my, I did a garden map so that I could remember where I planted everything. And they're coming along pretty well. Even though I don't get a lot of sun here, there is a better part of the morning. There is shade. But then it gets sunny towards the afternoon. So I thought it would do all right. So I'm kind of doing a lot of experimenting this year with the different places, the different areas around, and you'll see I've even planted some tomatoes out in my front yard, which is definitely doable if you don't have enough space, and but you have some bushes or whatever out in your front yard. There's places that you can plant food in and amongst your landscaping, and it can still look really nice. So this is all that I have right now. Some of the flowers that I planted from seed didn't come up, and I think it's because there's a chipmunk eating all my little seeds. So I'm going to plant some, so I'm going to try to plant some more here in a little while, and I'll talk about that in a minute. But then I came over here and I did another no dig, because this area right here was just an ugly, it was dirt. It was just dirt kind of like this with no grass. And I've wanted to do it for so many years, so I just went and did it. And I grabbed some of the bricks that we had some old bricks that we used for an area over by the shed that we got off of Craigslist. And I just used them kind of as a border. So it's nothing, it's not anything fancy. It's just a place where I can put some plants and it looks a lot better than it did. So now, da-da-da-da. First garden tour official of the year, walking into the garden. And we'll start over here with, and again, this is tomatoes. These are all Roma tomatoes, and they will start to get sun about noon. So it's about 11 o'clock now. So in about an hour, they'll get full sun for the whole rest of the day. So they're doing really well. And I've got some of my herbs here from last year and the year before. They've come back. The thyme and the chive have come back year after year, and it's just been really wonderful. I don't know. So I did plant some parsley and some basil, which is doing all right. They're a little small, but, and there's a ton of purslane everywhere, and that is just popping up. That's considered what they call a weed, but it isn't. It's edible. So all of these purslane are edible, and I've been putting them in my salad in the morning, and also giving them to the chickens as a little green. So I'll give that to the chickens. It tastes like spinach, purslane. It tastes like spinach, purslane does. It's very flavorful, very good. Just here's a disclaimer, make sure that if you're going to eat something out of the garden, that you're sure you know what it is. Foraging is a great skill to be able to know how to do, but you have to make sure that you know what you're eating. And this is good. And tomatoes, they're doing really well. They're starting to get buds. I did see one over here this morning. They're starting to get flowers. So that's exciting to me because I'm going to need a lot of tomatoes because we're going to be canning a lot of tomatoes this year. And I did plant some beans pretty late. I just planted these a couple of weeks ago. These are going to be the long beans. They look like they're about a foot long, and they're going to climb up the trellis and go all the way up here. And I did buy some flowers to put into my hanging baskets because my nasturtium died. So we went and got buy one, get one free, and the kids picked some of the flowers in here. And it really turned out pretty with this white. And then the white, this isn't that amazing? Those are so pretty. I just love those. I thought, wow, they really are pretty. Okay, so, oh, look at that. A nasturtium. I just noticed that. There is nasturtium coming out. Hello, nasturtium. Look at that. So they're in there. The seeds are in there. They weren't coming up, but now they are. Well, that's going to be neat to see how they thrive now. That's going to be wonderful. How exciting. And I've got some parsley, and I did plant some, these are flowers here. These are marigolds. I think those are the marigolds right there. And I think these are either bachelor buttons. I'm not sure. I'm going to have to go get that app and try to remember what I planted here. I just kind of planted a bunch of flower seeds around because I'm trying to get the pollinators to come in. And I did purchase a whole bunch of marigolds, and here's why. My mother and I discovered about 10 years ago that marigolds would keep the green hornworms off the tomatoes. So we just plant those, we would plant them around our tomatoes and our plants, and I hadn't had any trouble with pests in the past 10 years on my tomatoes. So because my some of my marigolds that I planted over here, like right here, I think that those are some, are not coming up fast enough. I wanted to get these in because the tomatoes are doing so well, and I wanted to make sure that those hornworms didn't come back and bother my tomato plants. This is a great pest control, everyone. It works. I've seen it work year after year after year. So that I know for sure. Although I'm no garden expert, this I know. And marigolds are great for that. And they're pretty. They make orange, and we bought a lot of different ones. My daughter picked the yellow ones, and then we got all those. So, and also this. This is just a little something that we thought was interesting, so we're going to plant that somewhere. So coming on over to the peppers, I have another hanging basket. And these are neat, too. These are called Night Sky, and they're speckled like the stars. I thought those were amazing. Beautiful. Okay, so over here, I planted some sunflowers, and they're coming up very well. And then this here is the borage jungle. And I'm going to have to, now I transplanted it from seed, and I had heard that they didn't do very well. And for a while, they looked like they were dying. And then all of a sudden, one day, just popped out, and there's a ton of them there. So I might move some of them away from this area and put them over in the other garden that I just showed you, because there's some space over there. There's some space over there. And then we've got cucumbers all lining this cattle panel along the back. And the cattle panel, if I pan back a little bit, it goes all the way up the back of the shed. And they're doing pretty well. This one here especially is really climbing, and there's a lot of flowers under there. So I'm hoping for a lot of fruit. There they are. And there's another one, cucumber. And here are the peppers that I purchased from a local nursery. And this one, they're starting to get peppers. Now I did, in another video, I had talked about how I had heard and I had seen how when they're really small and early, you pick off all of the buds so that they have a chance to grow. Now, what happened was I was still a little leery of that. So I just did one of them. I did this one over here where I was pulling off the buds, and it didn't seem to make a difference. This one's still pretty small, and there is a little fruit there. I don't know. Sorry about my camera. I'm just learning how to use this thing. So that's starting to happen. I'm not going to pull them anymore though, because I don't have a very long growing season as far as these go, and I'm starting to see peppers. There's another one. It's hard to see. I don't know. There. And then there's a bunch down here on this little one. And I just didn't feel right pulling them, so I'm just going to let them go. Seem to make a difference. And these to this one, and this one grew really tall anyway, and this one stayed small, and that one stayed small. This one stayed small even though I was pulling all of the blossoms off of it. So I don't know. I wouldn't do them on all of them just because I'm experimenting this year. I'm trying to figure out. This is my learning garden. I call this my learning garden, and I'm trying to learn a lot so that next year I'll be able to hit the ground running and really get going on a bigger garden. These are the carrots that I have to thin out a little bit. And they're a little late. I don't know what they're going to do. I might have to replant some carrots in the fall. We'll see what happens. And then I've got some tomatoes here. It's like a tomato bush. There's actually three plants there, and they're all growing up together inside the tomato cage. And they're doing well, and I'm keeping them pruned as best I can down at the bottom, because, like, see, for instance, this, you're going to want to make sure that they're not touching, that the leaves are not touching the ground, because that's how blight comes. So I'm just trying to keep those from touching the ground. And then I've got another bunch of sunflowers over here. I'm hoping that they grow up in time, that the tomatoes don't overtake them, and that they can get some. They look like they're doing all right. They're gonna make it. Sunflowers are great for the soil. They actually pull toxins out of the soil. So anywhere you have problem soil, plant a couple of sunflowers, and your soil will be fixed. They're a soil fixer. So now we're coming to something that's very exciting to me, and these are the potatoes. And I don't know if you can see. Those are the potato bags that I purchased, and I had been filling them, and now they're growing up so beautifully, and I can't wait to see how many potatoes I get out of here. That's going to be an exciting day. A potato patch. Now, to be honest with you, this is the best my peppers have ever looked, so I'm very excited about this. The peppers and potatoes are the coolest things, because I've not had good luck with peppers in the past. One time I tried potatoes was a big nothing. So this is exciting. Woo! Exciting! Garden! If you're a gardener, you understand. If you're not a gardener, you're probably not even watching. And now we're in the last part of the garden. This is my U-shaped garden bed, my original garden bed that we had back here. And I did plant some more tomatoes, because remember, I started so many and they all came up. So I've got little tomato patches everywhere, and they're all doing super well. So I'm very, very excited about being able to can them this year. And a little basil. That's another thing I learned about basil and tomatoes. They go very well together in sauce, but they also go together in the garden. And the reason is because the basil actually also deters pests because of its scent, and it draws the scent away of the tomato scent that the certain bugs like. The tomato worms. And over here, my zucchini. And of course, zucchini always does really well. This zucchini, when I transplanted it, looked terrible. And I just kept watering it and keeping it, you know, watered. And I did at the beginning, I did pull blossoms, because you can eat the blossoms. And so I put a bunch of blossoms in the freezer for us to have a little snack and treat later on in the year. And now I'm just letting them go, because now I'm not sure. I'm not seeing any fruit yet. So I'm hoping that they will get pollinated and then we'll start to see some fruit. But I know that they'll do well. I know that they'll do well, even though I'm not seeing any fruit yet because zucchini. Here, see, on this other side of the small trellis, I planted the same beans that I planted over on the other side. They're called a long bean, and they look like they're a foot long. I was just curious about them, and I'm reading that they're very good in stir fry. So I'm hoping that we get a lot of them and we can maybe save some over the winter too. Here is the big bean trellis. And this has two different kinds of beans on this side and two on the other side. So this bean is, I think this is just the green bean. This is just the plain green bean. No, they're so, I just love their little flowers. They're just so pretty, so sweet. And then over here, these are purple beans. These are the purple, the dark purple. And of course they have dark purple flowers, and they're growing up on that side and they're doing so well. They're starting to climb up. Such a beautiful place when this is completed. Oh, wow. I haven't been out here yet. The borage is coming out. Oh, look, guys, look. There it is. Look at how pretty. I just think that those flowers are so beautiful. Can you tell I like purple flowers? But look, this one was also looking really bad up until about a week ago, and it just perked right up and started to flower, and today is the first flower. How special. Hello, little borage. Bring in the bees. Bring in all the bees. Another basil. I just love basil. I love all things basil. I use basil in cooking constantly. I'm always using basil. And all the flowers on the beans. And here's some more tomatoes. Tomatoes is the big crop this year. These are all Roma tomatoes. And then the ones on the other side, the ones in the peppers are black creme, and then I have some Cherokee purple up in the front. I'm in the front yard. Oh, here's my dill patch. And this dill right here had volunteered from last year, or from 2 years ago, because I hadn't done anything last year. And then I planted a few of the ones that I started, and they're coming along. I don't know how big they're going to get. They'll get bigger. But I was hoping, the reason why I planted so much dill is because they draw the swallowtail butterfly, and I love swallowtail butterfly, and they're so fun, and they're so beautiful. So I was hoping for that. Here was my radish patch, and I pulled the radishes because they started to go to seed, and I got some of the seed, and now I just didn't know what to put here, so I am trying just a small patch of delicata squash. That's the squash that has the stripes. They're kind of smaller and oblong shaped, and they have like green and yellow and orange stripes. I'm hoping that they come up. I have had trouble with seeds here, so I sprinkled a bunch of bone meal and blood meal on it to try to deter that little chipmunk that keeps eating the seeds around here. This broccoli and celery I had seeded in the winter sowing containers, so I'm just kind of, I'm wondering if the broccoli is even going to do anything this year. I'm not sure. I know broccoli's more of a cool weather thing, so I'm probably going to replant some in August to try to get a fall crop. So my mother gave me a little Swiss chard, so that's starting to pop up a little bit. Now here's the beets, and they're doing all right. And I have also, these are some of the kale that I had planted, and I'm pulling the kale a little bit. It's starting to get pesty looking. So I'm giving this kale now to the chickens when we take some into them for them to have a little treat. Now here is another bean that I planted a little later. This is the Cherokee wax bean. So this is a little bit behind the others on the other side, but it's doing well. It's coming right along the way that it should. And these are my snap peas, which again, I probably should have planted earlier in the year. I don't know. I'm not sure. They are growing. Look at this sweet flower. Kind of almost looks like a snapdragon. It's kind of from the same family, I think, as the snapdragon. So that's coming along and they're growing. But snap peas, they are more of a cooler weather thing too. So I just kind of grew them. I got a late start on my spring garden because the soil wasn't ready. So I put them in anyway, just to see what would happen. And they are growing. And they are beautiful, so we'll see what happens. Tulsi basil, and I think I talked about this before in my other video, and it smells like candy. It's so amazing. I stand here when I'm watering, and I just, you can smell the scent of the candy in the air. It's so, so nice. Such a beautiful, beautiful plant. I have to look at the borage one more time. Borage. Love it. Oh, that's going to bring the bees, I'm sure. Okay, so it's 4th of July weekend, and we are going to be experiencing some picnics and parties. So if you hear any music or anything in the background, that's what that is. It's our neighbors that have wonderful parties every year, and they're having a great time today. I did want to come on over and show you how Sean is doing on the chicken coop before we go and show you the chickens and how they're growing. So here we are, so let's check it out. Here is the chicken coop, and it's coming along really well, and Chappie likes it. She's excited. And well, right over here, this wall here is going to have the door going out for the chickens into the run, which is going to run along here probably to about there, and that's going to be the run. And underneath too, they're going to have to go under. And then Sean made these nesting boxes that are, there's going to be two nesting boxes separated by a middle panel. And do you want to show them the door?
Yeah, this will be the door. It'll hinge on the bottom so we can just reach in and get our eggs.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Here,
wait a minute. Okay.
And there'll be a glass window here with hardware cloth behind it that will swing open, and we'll be able to keep it open for ventilation.
Yeah, that's going to be nice. And they're going to get light in the morning too.
And then over here, we're going to have another window that swings open from here, and there will be also an access door that will lock and open up like this. We can tie it back, and when it's time to change their litter, we can open this bottom door and just shovel out all the old stuff.
Yeah, into the wheelbarrow. Now, there's going to be also the roosts are going to go right along where that beam is, right?
Yeah, that's right. We'll have at least 1 foot per bird to roost on.
Okay. Chappie just stole one of your boards. She's going to... Is that the board? Is that a board she's supposed to have? She stole one of your boards.
Let's see, what is this?
I don't even know where that came from.
This is a shingle for a fort.
Oh, she stole the shingle off the fort. Okay. It's time for lunch. You want lunch, Chappie? Chappie, Hey, Chappie, do you want lunch? Okay, so here they are. They're on their outing. They're outside, their daily outside outing. Right this way. And they're getting so big. Look at how big they're getting from the first time we brought them out. And now to now, they're almost too big to be in this little guinea pig thing. Let's see if I can come down here. And they've changed so much too since they were babies. Their feathers are coming in and they're all so different, so beautiful. They love it out here. Hello. Hello, my little chickies. Hi, Juggernaut. Hi, Anne. There's Rachel. Now they're all curious to see. Aww. So I hope you enjoyed our garden tour. I hope you enjoyed our update on our chickens. We are really busy around here, as I'm sure you are. I know that your gardens are growing. I know that this has been a beautiful summer. We've had a lot of beautiful days. And I just hope you're enjoying your 4th of July weekend. I hope you enjoyed your 4th of July weekend. And I just want to remind you that to start where you are, do what you can. It's never too late. And some people say, stay safe, but I say, stay free. Bye. They love it out here.